Hi everyone, today I'm going to be taking a look at this LEGO Star Wars set. It is number 75278 DO from the Rise of Skywalker movie. So this set costs £65 in the UK and it comes with 519 pieces and one minifig. It says one minifig, but it's the mini DO, so I don't really consider that a minifig, so I'll give them half a minifig for that. But yeah, I should say I'm filming in a different room, so apologies if the lighting's not as good as usual. So here is the box. So I know some people don't like the box because they think it's too plain, but I quite like it. I mean, I think the Star Wars, the box art is good at the top. I suppose it's a little bit unusual. If you've seen the film, obviously Dio is quite a quirky, sweet little droid, so the background is a bit murky looking, I suppose. Nice box art on the side. Yes, it shows you the height, how the head moves around. That's kind of it really for the box. And so here is the actual set. So we'll start off with this. So it's got the kind of UCS style plaque. It doesn't really tell you that much. You can probably read that quite quickly. There is the little tiny one. So this is nice. And then here is the actual model itself. So I guess really I should start off by saying that I do like it. I think it looks good. And it will especially go nicely next to the Porg and BB-8. But I do think it's definitely well overpriced. I mean, looking at the basic, the price per piece is 12.5p, which is not awful, but it's not great. And even if you don't look at that as a way of checking out value, I think just for what you get, there's not much there for £65, I don't think. And when you consider BB-8 and the Porg, I can't remember the prices of those. I think they were a bit more. So I'm sure BB-8 was a bit more, but they are definitely bigger, maybe around the same height. I'll grab them in a minute, but in terms of how chunky they are and how many bricks go into them, there's a lot more in those two compared to this. So yeah, I guess get the negative out of the way first. It is overpriced. Try and pick it up on a discount, or at least if you're going to get it at full price, maybe try and get it when there's double points or some kind of giveaway or something. I mean, that's when I got this, was for May the 4th, I got another set, and then I got the Death Star 2 battle freebie that they gave away, and double points, so yeah, it wasn't as bad. But anyway, so if we have a quick look around the side, so I think the stand is quite nice. How this shape is made up is, you can just see there, you can slightly adjust these however you like. They do move a little bit. Some are fixed and then some move. So it's just two of the like Technic hoses that go through the centre of white bricks, so two holes, and then with these on top. So there's like 24 of those, I think, that go around. And then you have some more solid pieces underneath, keeping it all together. And then you kind of make two circular plates on either side. So I think it goes together well. I think it was quite an enjoyable build, because it was sort of more unusual, I guess. Slightly different techniques used for it. And then you have this tubing, everything that leads up to the head. So you have two knobs here. This one is to move the head around, so you can do 360. And while we're there, might as well look at the back. So you can adjust these however you like. So yeah, it goes all the way around. And then we have another knob down here that moves the head, tilts it back and forth. So you can get some movements in there. But obviously this kind of set is not, it's not a playset. I mean, I think Logan's just done a little bit of that, and that's about it. This is a set to kind of collect, and yeah, for what it's meant to be, a detailed model of Dio, then I think it's very good. But I just can't really get past the price. It's just too much. But yeah, so that's kind of it. There's not much more to say really. If you like the look of it and you want it, then go for it, because even though it's expensive, I did want it, especially to go with the Porg and BB-8, which I'll grab now. So you can see them all together. Let's try not to drop BB-8. Can I get him with one hand? Because he's quite heavy. So let's get them all lined up. So you can see, in terms of size, might make you think it's not such bad value, but a lot less pieces. You can see height is fine, but definitely a lot more goes into the Porg and BB-8 in particular. I can't remember the price. I'm sorry, I should have looked that up first, but you can just see, if you've not seen BB-8 before, how chunky he is. He's got obviously all different features and bits and pieces, but I think together, though, they will look good together. So, yeah, not much more to say. I think it's good, but a bit pricey. But if you like it, then yeah, treat yourself. And I'll be having these all nicely displayed together, and I think that's probably the best way to do it. And I do think Dio looks better actually with them too than on his own. Yeah, so there we are. Thanks for watching, and I will talk to you again soon.